In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve a 5x5 Rubik's Cube. Check out my other video showing you how to solve a 2x2 Rubik's Cube, a 3x3, a 4x4, and even a 5x5. As explained in the 4x4 video, when using algorithms with a 4x4 or a 5x5, I just need to explain a little addition. We still use F, B, L, R, etc. for front, back, left, right. But when it's the outer face, it's a capital letter. So if I said R, that would be R. But if we have a lowercase letter, that would be the inner face of that letter. So that would be a small r. If the algorithm tells us to turn both, that would be a capital R and a small r in brackets. And the same if you want to turn inverse or anticlockwise, that would be capital R inverse. This would be lowercase r inverse. If we add capital R and lowercase r in brackets together, inverse, with an I after it, that would be that. And if we want to turn them twice, 180 degree turn, it would be R2. Or if it was the interface, it would be a small R2. Should be this. And if it was both, it would be capital R, small r in brackets, 2. And when I'm doing the small r, you see me do that. I turn both and turn the outer one back just because it can be quite difficult just to push the one on its own. That time it worked, but if it's not lined up perfectly, it's really difficult. So when you see a small r, it's actually that. But what I'm doing, just to make it easier, I'm doing that. But that is a small r. Small r. Small r. And it's the same for all the other letters. Same with L, same with F, same with B, U, D, etc. Okay, now we have the Rubik's Cube in this position. We basically just have a scrambled 3x3. And you just complete this Rubik's Cube exactly the same you would a 3x3. And you'll be pleased to know from now on, when you've got every edge completed, there are no other parity errors that you can run into. This is now exactly the same as a 3x3, and you complete it as a 3x3. So sometimes you don't get where all these match up. Sometimes you do get another parity error. Sometimes you will get this. Sometimes you will run into this parity error where you have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 complete, but you've left with 2 incomplete. This is like a very similar parity error that you get on the 4x4 where you're just left with 2. When you've got just 3 left, when you correct one pair, they all fall into place like it just did for me. But sometimes you don't get 3 left over, you get 2 left over like this. Sometimes the 3 will fall into place, sometimes it will leave you with 2. When you've just got 2, there's no way you can get out of it. So you bring that one together, well, you've got 3, 3, 3, 3, so you can't bring any of those down. The same with here. And on the back, you can't even bring one of these to the top to use either because they're 3. So every time you match this one, you put it to the top, you brought another one down, you'd break another one. You're like stuck in an infinite loop because you've only got 2 left. It's called a parity error. Stuck in an infinite loop. If you're stuck in this parity error, you need to put them in a certain position. You need to put them in the position they're in now. So when you turn them, they line up like that. So the pairs are both at the bottom and the singles are both at the top. You don't want the single at the bottom, pair at the top, and the other side, a pair at the bottom, single at the top, like this. See, I have the pair at the bottom, single at the top. This side, I have a single at the bottom, pair at the top. You don't want it like this. You need to alter your cube. So you have both pairs at the bottom, both singles at the top. Once you've got them in this position, you need to turn this front face to the top and turn it to the right. So you've got the singles, what would be the lowercase r or the small r. Remember, this is a large r, this one inside is a small r, basically in here, and the two pairs on the left hand side. So the singles to the right of the center and the pair to the left. When you've got in this position, you need to perform this algorithm, which is double L in brackets I, U2, double L in brackets I, U2, F2, double L in brackets I, F2, double R in brackets U2, double R in brackets I, U2, double L in brackets 2. So let's do that. So it's double L in brackets I, or inverse, U2, double L I, U2, F2, double L in brackets I, F2, double R, U2, double R I, U2, double L 2. And that has corrected the parity area of these two edges. So as I said, once you've got all the center pieces completed, and then you've matched all the edge pieces into threes, you've now got a scrambled 3x3 basically, and you just complete this exactly the same you would a 3x3. You'd start by making your cross, then you do the corners. Once you've completed the green face, then we do what would be stage 3 on the 3x3 Rubik's Cube. Then we would make the cross using stage 4 of the 3x3. This would be the through-rough algorithm. Again, I'm not really explaining how to do a 3x3. You should already know how to solve a 3x3 if you're doing a 5x5. If not, you go check my 3x3 tutorial out. Then you position one and you do the algorithm for positioning these edge pieces. This would be stage 5. The next step is the corners. You find one that's in position and then an algorithm with that one in the top right. This will be stage 6 on the 3x3. And then once you've got all the corners in position, it's just rotating the corners into position using stage 7 of the 3x3. This is the RIDIRD algorithm. It's exactly the same as a 3x3. And there we have a solved 5x5. Hope it helped, guys, and thanks for watching.